Hi friends, welcome to your De-Stress Fest Candlelight Yoga. Go ahead and grab yourself some tea, grab yourself some pillows and blankets, a couch cushion. Go ahead and grab anything that will make you comfortable. This is going to be a really slow, chilled out, passive stretching and relaxation yoga session. And you know, we are calling it candlelight yoga, but as you know, there are certain areas of the school that do not allow fire or candles. So you can use Christmas lights, you can use the battery operated candlelight. So just know that that's always an option for you. So I'll go ahead and set up my space here. Attendance, if you would like to get credit for pin, I put it in the chat. So go ahead and grab all of your things. I just have some pillows from the bedroom. I've got some blankets. I've got my chair, but your chair could be your couch cushion or the end of your bed. Just anything to make you comfortable. And then we'll just start either lying down or in a comfortable seat. And let's take a moment to get into the breath. So feel free to soften or close your eyes. And then we'll inhale to the count of four. Exhale to the count of four. Taking some nice deep inhales through the nose. And letting your breath fall as you open your mouth and let something go. See if you could settle into this space, into this moment. Let go of everything else. Let this be your time to focus on self-care. As we get into finals and towards the end of the semester and towards the holiday season, we tend to carry a lot of stress with us. So let this be your time for self-care as this becomes more and more important to ground, to take care of yourself, and to heal from all the stressors that you've maybe endured the past month or semester. The stressors, maybe emotional stressors, maybe stress in your body, physical stressors. Let's utilize this time. Continuing to breathe, inhale to the count of four. And exhale to the count of four. And as you continue to breathe, imagine that you're actually breathing from your heart space. And as you inhale, the heart expands in 3D from the front to the sides to the back as it inflates. And exhale is a strengthening of the heart as you sense and feel the recoil. So our heart is puffing up and expanding with our inhales and strengthening with our exhales. Take two more breaths with our heart at the center of our focus. As a collected community, inhale through the nose. Open your mouth, let it fall. Again,
through the nose. Open your mouth, let it fall. Last time, inhale through the nose. Open your mouth, let it go. And go ahead and blink your eyes open. We'll come to a tabletop position. So stacking your shoulders on top of your wrist. Wrist parallel. With your fingertips facing front, and then our knees about hips distance apart, will flow through what's called cat-cow. So cow is dropping the belly button towards the ground, hugging the shoulder blades together, point the tailbone to the sky, and then look up. As you exhale, reverse this, press the floor away, dome the back, separate the shoulder blades, really stretching out the spine. Inhale to cow. Exhale to cat. Inhale to cow. Exhale to cat. See if you can move with your breath. Continue to flow at your own pace, finding the rhythm of your own breath as you flow from your cat to your cow. We'll take two more rounds. And then next spine. We'll come into what's called fire toes next, so tuck your toes underneath you. And then sit back onto your heels. The more that we sit forward, the less pressure, the more that we sit back and possibly stack our shoulders on top of our hips, the more stretch and sensation we get on our feet. So know that if this is too much sensation, you can always lean forward or plant your hands onto the ground. We'll take a couple of head rolls with this. So just drawing circles with your nose and breathing for four, three, two, and one. Reverse your circle. Drawing a circle with your nose for four, three, two, and one. Come back to your tabletop position. Untuck your toes. Give them a little bit of a pat on the ground. And then to ankle stretch, come to sitting on your heels. If this is a bit for your knees, know that you can place a pillow right behind you to lift yourself up and to help not go so deep. You can stack more pillows or as many pillows and blankets underneath you as you need to. So right here, this might be enough of a stretch. If you want more sensation or if you feel like you can go a little bit deeper, again, practicing self-care, you can bring your hands behind you. You can begin to lean back and then possibly lifting your knees off the ground. This actually does not feel good in my body, so I'm going to leave my knees planted and just lean back just a hair. So I can stretch the tops of my feet. Find that four count inhale and four count exhale. And then we're going for sensation, not pain. Maybe bringing in the affirmation, I am connected to my body. I give it all the care I can. shift your hips to the side and bring your legs out in front of you. Give them a little bit of a shake. Go ahead and grab your props, whether that's a pillow, a blanket, a chair, a couch cushion. We'll come into what's called half a butterfly. So if you ever remember a butterfly from gym class, right? We'll be doing half butterfly. So extending our right leg out, tucking our left foot in. Couple options with this. This might be enough, right? Just working right here and working on extending the spine. We might need to even lean back, and that's okay. We might want to utilize our chair or couch cushion, fold one hand on top of the other and place the forehead onto the stacked hands. You can also take your pillow, right? Maybe one to two pillows, and kind of round your spine and then release. And then for those who want a different variation, not better, not worse, just different, depending on what you are wanting to feel, and you might want to explore this yourself, you can reach towards your foot. And that gets into the side body a little bit. So one is not better or worse than the other. It just depends on kind of what you're feeling or what feels best in your body. For me, I'm feeling the forward fold. So we'll take a little bit of time to be here in the breath. And see if you could, again, come back to the four count inhales and the four count exhales. Deepening the breath and noticing the sensations. Spaces that might be tight. And we are about halfway. So if you want to adjust yourself by adding a pillow or adding a blanket, or if you want to go a little deeper, you can remove a pillow and go just a hair deeper if that feels okay for you. Again, we are not looking for pain. We are just looking for sensation, and the sensation is up to you. If you want lighter sensation or heavier sensation, that's going to be up to you where you want and where you want to adjust your body to that. Switch out our legs. So slowly bring your right leg in. Stretch your right leg out. And then again, find what variation feels okay for you. Whether that's utilizing the chair, the pillows, a forward fold, or a fold towards the leg. It is totally up to you. So take a moment to adjust. and to see what you're feeling. And we've got about two minutes in this hold, and I will let you know when the halfway point is, if there's something that you want to adjust. So again, just feel free to explore. You don't have to stay stagnant. If something's uncomfortable, you know, adjust yourself so you are more comfortable. You don't have to force yourself into a shape. It doesn't have to look a certain way. It doesn't have to feel a certain way. But we want to make sure that it is not uncomfortable. Or, I'm sorry, it's not painful. A little discomfort is okay, but a lot of discomfort we want to maybe adjust. So we are about halfway through. If you wanted to remove a pillow, add a pillow, adjust. Space expanding with the inhales and strengthening with the exhales. Begin to rise. We'll come into full butterfly. So full butterfly is feet together, knees open. This could be a wide diamond. It could be a short diamond, just depending on what feels okay for you. And again, we could have the chair, right? We can have the pillows. We can even have our elbows up and our hands on our forehead as we allow ourselves to relax into this pose. So I'll give you the halfway point again. Feel free to breathe and adjust as you feel is necessary. Maybe closing the eyes. Heart space expand. So we are about halfway through. If you would like to adjust, change positions, open up your diamond or close it. Let the head feel heavy. Let the sit bones feel heavy as your knees descend towards the earth. perhaps aside. Go ahead and take your hands, place them on the outside of the thighs, and assist your knees to come in. Separate your feet, and then windshield wiper your knees back and forth. We'll come into full butterfly, or I'm sorry, for we'll come into dragonfly. So butterfly with knees together. Dragonfly is legs extended. So same type of thing. If we want the chair in front of us, if we want pillows and blankets, right, for a forward fold, feel free to adjust yourself. Sit bones pointed towards the earth or behind us. We don't want them underneath us because that grounds the lower back, and we really want to see if we can take a little bit of pressure off the lower back. We're about halfway through. Feel free to adjust. Maybe that's coming out of the pose a little bit and working on maybe lengthening the spine, because we might have gone a little too deep, and that's okay. Can we have the compassion for ourselves to pull back when we need to? Part of self-care, right? Setting those boundaries and knowing when to push ourselves, but not so far that we're toppling over our edge, right? We're finding our edge, but we're not toppling over. We're practicing self-care, so we pull back, know where our boundaries are, we know where our guardrails are. Upper body, if you haven't already. Shake out your legs and slowly bring them in towards the center. Go ahead and turn up. Actually, you don't have to turn. I will turn. Slowly lower yourselves onto the ground, onto your backs, and what's called bound ankle pose. So just like our butterfly pose, our feet are together, our knees are open. You can take some blankets and place them underneath your knees for a little bit of support, or maybe some pillows. And then slowly lower yourself onto your back. Maybe a hand on the tummy or abdomen or heart space as you notice the rise and the fall of the chest or the abdomen. Coming into that four count breath. Healing takes time. I surrender to the process. Healing takes I surrender to the process. Go ahead and extend your legs out long. And then we'll come into what's called supported bridge. So if you have some pillows or blankets, go ahead and stack them underneath your sacrum. So your sacrum is kind of that bony, it's basically your tailbone, right? It's that bony spot. Underneath your tushy. So a couple of blankets underneath the bottom, feet grounded. Knees can come into touch if that feels okay, or they can stay straight. If you want to open up the hip flexors a little bit, you can extend your legs out, but notice if there's pressure on your lower back. If that's too much pressure on your lower back, come to bent knees. And then we'll just be here with the breath. Coming back to noticing the rise and the fall, the expansion of the heart space as you inhale, the strengthening of the heart as you exhale. Notice if you're clenching your jaw. Can you breathe into the space to help release it? Notice if there's tension between your eyebrows. Can you smooth it out? Relax your eyebrows. Pressing into your heels, remove the blankets from underneath you or pillows or what have you. Slowly lower one vertebrae at a time and then windshield wiper your knees back and forth. Center. Bring your knees into your chest. It can rock from side to side as you massage out your lower back. And when you're ready, let your knees fall all the way over to the right. Cactus your arms or open up your arms like a book. Release your left shoulder on the ground. You can take pillows or blankets if you want to place them in between your legs for a little extra support, if that feels okay. You can straighten your legs, keep them bent. You can gaze over your left shoulder. Either way, can you surrender into the earth? Can you trust its support? exhale, can you let your left shoulder descend a little bit closer to the earth? Off the roof of your mouth. Let your teeth separate. Go ahead and remove the blanket from underneath or in between your legs if you have them there. Inhale your knees back through center. Rock from side to side. Again, massaging out the lower back. And then allow your knees to fall over to the left as you cactus your arms or open up your hands like a book. Again, taking the blanket or the pillow, option to place it in between your knees. Option to extend your legs or possibly gaze over your right shoulder. Utilizing the breath to slowly sink a little bit deeper into relaxation. Utilizing the breath to release any tension. Know that although you are gravitating towards stillness, know that you can adjust yourself. If something does not feel right, you can adjust yourself. You could decrease the twist by placing pillows underneath both of your knees to lift your knees. Adjusted. See if you can come back into stillness. Come back to the breath. Come back to the vision of your heart expanding and strengthening. Your knees back through center, rock yourself from side to side, massage out your lower back, and then plant both feet onto the ground, toe heel your feet a little bit wider than hips, let your knees come into touch for constructive rest, maybe placing a hand on the abdomen or on the heart or on the ground if you feel like you want some grounding. Back to the breath. Maybe utilizing the affirmation, self-compassion and kindness are my greatest tools to heal. Self-compassion and kindness are my greatest tools to heal. I choose to use them. Self-compassion and kindness are my greatest tools to I choose to use them.
Back to the breath. Extend your legs out. And then bring your arms up overhead. Roll over onto your side carefully. And then carefully roll onto your tummy. Place your elbows underneath your shoulders for Sphinx pose. Your Sphinx pose can be active, or with your shoulders down and your head lifted. It could be passive, hunching through your shoulders, letting your head fall towards the earth. A lot for some, including myself, so I'll keep my elbows down. And then we'll come into crocodile with elbows facing out, one hand stacked on top of the other, releasing the forehead onto the hands. Maybe rocking back and forth, massaging out the space between your eyebrows, bringing some space in between your teeth as you let your jaw release.
Right hand, stretch it out towards the right. So I'm taking my right hand and I'm stretching my arm towards the right. Left hand underneath the shoulder, begin to open up your heart and your chest as you roll over onto your right shoulder. So this is a little bit of a shoulder and a heart opener. Let your left foot find the wall behind you. Stretch out the left arm. Place the right hand underneath your shoulder. Open up your heart space as you roll over onto it. Let your right foot find the floor behind you. Breathe.
sorry. Place your stack your hands. Take your right knee, bend it and move it towards the right elbow. Release your forehead to the ground.
We call this half frog pose. You can deepen this. This might be enough.
You can deepen this by placing a blanket underneath your knee. I'm not going to because this is good for me.
You can also place a blanket underneath your heart or your chest if you want to make this less intense.
Again, if you want to deepen the pose, you can place a pillow or a blanket underneath your knee to intensify the sensation. Right leg. Go ahead and wag your tail. When you're ready, we'll set it up for left. So if you want to stay on your pillow or possibly stack your hands, we'll bend our left knee towards our left elbow. And then again, release the forehead to the mat.
Or possibly a pillow underneath the chest. Either way, we're releasing the jaw.
Adjust yourself, place a pillow underneath you, underneath your legs, underneath your heart. Reverse the stacking of your hands, possibly. Trust what I'm feeling. I respect. respect my boundaries. I trust what I'm feeling. I respect my boundaries. Lift your upper body, right? Remove the pillow. Extend your leg out long. Press yourself up onto your tabletop position. Sit back onto your heels. We'll come into embryo pose. Embryo pose is kind of like child's pose. If you would like to place a blanket underneath you, it's kind of like child's pose where we're releasing our forehead towards the earth. Hands are coming down towards the feet. If this is a little snug for you, know that you can take embryo pose with the chair. Okay? So hands can still be down by your side and you can release your forehead onto the chair. We're still getting that same action. So this is kind of just a nice restorative pose, a grounding pose where we can breathe. Sit your hips to the side. We'll come down into a comfortable lying down position. If you do have a chair or a couch cushion, feel free to utilize that. Otherwise, you can lie straight on your back. If you'd like to come into astronaut's pose, feel free to place your feet up like so and then release yourself. You can place whatever pillows and blankets behind you, underneath you, to be comfortable. And we'll come into what's called triangle breath. So it is a 4-count inhale, a 4-count hold, and then a 6-count exhale. So we'll inhale, 2, 3, 4. Hold, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Inhale, 2, 3, 4. Hold, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Inhale, 2, 3, 4. Hold, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Continue on your own, at your own pace, guiding yourself triangle breath. The hold, right, that pause, and the extended stress, release tension, and tap into our parasympathetic rest and digest nervous system. So this is a breath that you can utilize before bed. This is a breath that you can utilize when you feel anxious, when you need to breath. And the breath is always a tool that you can use because it's always there. Got a couple more rounds on your own. Inhaling for the count of four. Holding. Exhaling for the count of six. We'll take two more rounds. With your second round, let your breath rise and fall at its natural pace. And then we'll end our practice with two moments of silence or rest. So, that could be in your astronaut's pose if you want to go for the traditional resting pose or shavasana. You can stretch your legs out long, take them down from this chair and stretch them out long, or feel free to stay in your astronaut's pose. And then in those two moments of silence, back to the breath. The thoughts will rise and fall just as the breath. Let them go as if you're observing them floating away like clouds. And come back to the breath for grounding. over onto your favorite side, taking a moment to transition. And press yourself up into a comfortable seat. We'll seal our practice with 3 cleansing breaths as a collected community. So we'll inhale through the nose. Open your mouth, let it fall. Again, inhale through the nose. Open your mouth, let it fall. Last time, inhale through the nose. Open your mouth, let it fall. Rub them together, feel the heat, feel the warmth. When you're ready, place them on an area of your body that you would like to feel healing from. Know that you have the tools for self-care. Utilizing the breath, utilizing stillness. That self-care these last couple weeks. When you're ready, go ahead and blink your eyes open. Thank you so much, Panthers, for joining me. My name's Melissa. If you have any comments, questions, concerns, go ahead and DM us. We have some more yoga events coming out in the spring semester, so make sure that you keep an eye out on for PIN. Thank you so much for joining me this evening, and good luck on the rest of your semester. We'll see y'all.